Good day. We're continuing our sequence of interviews with most prominent and interesting people who work in waste and recycling, people who deal with ecological issues. And today I would like to introduce to you a true hero, a man whose life reminds of a plot of a very interesting, fantastic movie. Better yet, Space Odyssey. Edwin Terwald, a good friend of ours. I will now let him take over.
Our project is a project to inspire the world to use waste materials, stop littering materials, and try to work circular instead of linear. So what we have decided is we are looking in our trash bins at home and see what we can find of materials. And plastics were the majority of materials in our trash bins. And then we thought, well, if we think this is worthless, why do we not change our mind and think this is very valuable? And there we start, and then we started to overthink the situation. What can we make out of it? How can we add this value to this material so that we can do nice things with it in near future? So we decided to use this material to build a car which will be powered by solar energy. So this project is a sustainable project to inspire to work zero waste and zero emission. But no guts, no story. So we also decided to drive with this car to the geographical South Pole, the most thrilling continent of the world, the most extreme situation. And only to say to the world, well, if we can do this on Antarctica, so driving in a plastic car built of waste materials and powered by solar energy, then the circular idea can be implemented all over the world.
It certainly sounds very unusual. Do you perhaps feel yourself like a hero of a cosmic blockbuster?
Well, thanks for the compliment. Yes, it is fantastic. Yes, it is outrageous, this project. And hopefully this will indeed inspire others to do similar things. No, I'm not a hero. I'm just a regular guy, and this makes the story more interesting, because if we can show the world that even a regular guy, and together with our team, because it is a cooperation of quite a few people, if we can achieve to build this solar Voyager, and we already did. And if we can achieve the geographical South Pole on solar power, then everyone can do a similar thing. So with this project, we show the world that if you think otherwise, see materials not as worthless and throw it away, but see it as material which is very worthful and useful. And if you change your mind from linear to circular thinking, then you can achieve the most marvelous things in near future. And this is also the reason we are willing to achieve this geographical South Pole, because south, the most southern part of the world, is the geographical South Pole, and south on the compass is 180 degrees. And this is the way of our thinking today. We should think 180 degrees different than we did before.
I think you definitely blew away the minds of quite a few people with this project. You definitely make people see waste from a completely different perspective. You make people understand that we as humans are capable of making some real and useful things out of waste that are not used in an intelligent way. I'm very curious about your journey. It's very risky. It's quite a step for a mankind, but it's a dangerous one. Could you tell me about the distance you're planning to cover on the Solar Voyager and how much time you think it will take to do what you're planning to achieve?
2,300 kilometers in total. And this is in the rough situation of the midland of Antarctica. So it is cold there, very cold, windy, and there is nothing. You cannot live there as a human. There are no animals, there is no vegetation, there is no bacteria, nothing. Only us but the Solar Voyager. And this Solar Voyager is, I'm not the only hero. There are quite a few, because it all started with the youth in the Netherlands who was starting with urban mining. They collected the material. And they decided to pick up waste plastic from the ground in our cities. And they were not ashamed for that. They were happy to do this, and together we collected a lot of material. We changed this waste plastic into a filament by extruding, and in 3D printers we have printed the Solar Voyager. And this printing process is not one printer printing once the Solar Voyager, but printing building blocks. And the building blocks are similar to this one. This is a hexagonal building block. We call it Hexcore. It's very light, very strong. And the Solar Voyager is in total built up from 5,000 of those pieces. And all those heroes are mentioned in each block. So each block is unique. For each block we have a certificate, and on that certificate we mention the youth who were collecting this material by urban mining. And now the most important thing, they also gave us the most precious thing they had. And that is their ideas about a circular future. And this is a sort of message which is inside of this hex core. So if we reach the geographical South Pole, there is a car in total built up from 5,000 pieces. And in each piece, there is a message containing the message of the youth, which can inspire the world much more than us traveling to this geographical South Pole itself. And there is another thing also to make it complete. Okay. There is not also a group of heroes who decided to step on board of a tall ship, which will be started in the Netherlands and is sailing to the end of the world, to Ushuaia. And it will be done in 3 legs. And on board, there is a group of approximately 25 up to 30 youngsters in the age of 18 up to 25. And they are sailing the tall ship to Chile, the end of the world. And in the meantime, they also are trying to solve problems they have received from the industry in the transformation from linear business models to circular business models. And in each harbor, they will arrive, they hand over their solutions to the industry, and we will make sure that they will implement that, by the way. And in those three steps, they bring our Solar Voyager to Izuaya, and from there our journey will start on the extreme continent of Antarctica. So it is an expedition which started in the first time with an impossible situation. Can we build a Solar Voyager from waste plastic? And at the moment we are in the phase that we indeed could do that. The next step will be sailing to the end of the world and solving all kinds of problems from the industry with the new generation. And if we have achieved that, then we will show as a final piece of our complete expedition, we will drive to the geographical South Pole.
Edwin, could you tell me about the idea behind Zero Waste? Do you support the program from the economic side, or are you ecologically oriented? And is there any profit at all when we look at things from the side of ecology?
There is a commercial possibility with this concept. And we already started with that, and we called it a Zero Waste Center in the Netherlands. This is a sort of advisory business or consultancy business to help companies to avoid waste. Waste is costing them a lot of money, and we can change, we can make money out of it by introducing another way of thinking, by changing the procedures, by changing the human behavior in the company. And this can be a business model for us. But first, and this is very important for us in the coming years, we will show that we can put our money where our mouth is. First, experience it by ourselves and show the world that we can do it also in extreme situations, can make the idea of zero waste working. So first we should finish our campaign.
Okay, and would you say that the Solar Voyager project is capable of improving the ecology in general? Could similar project help changing the way people treat ecology? Will this really help make people see things differently? What would you say?
The project itself will not change the world because it is too small. But the story, the experiment, and the spin-offs out of this experiment will indeed help us to change our businesses and our behavior. So I see it as an inspirational project, which will ignite initiatives in companies. Although they are small, or maybe they are big, that doesn't matter. You have to try it, and do not be afraid that it is uncomfortable, because our project in total is very, very uncomfortable, and that makes a nice story. So similar to our projects, please start in your businesses an experiment to see if you can make your steps through the sustainable business.
Edwin, I also heard a lot of ecologists say that we have reached the point of no return when we can no longer restore the ecological situation on Earth and its primal state. What do you think about this? Does the Earth still has a chance to stand all that has been done to it over so many years?
I am not a scientist to give you the right answer in this, but I believe that we have to do our utmost. We have to try to change it as far as we can do. And this is a challenge I see as a very positive thing. So don't hesitate, do your utmost and your best to change the negative situation into a very positive situation.
Do you feel any support from the government at what you do? What about communities? How do people feel about the whole idea?
I feel very supported. At the first hand, by a big group of volunteers who are more than willing to help building Solar Voyager and to succeed this project. On the other hand, we have more than 32 companies who are delivering material, knowledge, and money to make it happen. And step by step, we are growing. And that's a good thing. We have to build up the community and make it as big as possible. It should be a global community who is willing to fight for a better world and willing to experiment in all kinds of situations to find solutions, to find successful ways to transform our linear economy into a circular economy. So I feel the strength from this community already, and it will be growing in the coming month and year.
Edwin, could you give a word of advice to people out there? What is that small step people should take to change the situation in their own very complicated lives?
Well, the advice can be on two ways. The first one is join us in our project, and it's an open innovation module, so everything you hear from us and everything you experience with us can be useful in your own situation, and you can adapt it and use it in any way you want. So that will help others to find more knowledge and information how to handle this in your own situation. The other thing is try to be curious about your own behavior and about your own situation. If you're throwing things away, ask yourself, why do I do this? And is it really worth it? Let's change it. First change it in your mind and say to yourself, well, I'm not willing to throw it away. I will use it. But for what? And how? And this will make you stronger in time. Because you have to find solutions, you have to be in contact with others, you have to be curious about the situation. And by practicing this, you will see that your behavior will be changed from a normal standard behavior into a sort of 2.0 innovative behavior which will help you to survive in coming years, and what will help us to change our economy into a circular economy.
Edwin, before we finish, I would like to say that in my eyes, you are a true hero. It is a very right and serious thing to do. From the bottom of my heart, I wish you luck, and I hope you will successfully finish your wonderful journey. I hope that when you will finish your quest, we will meet again for a Skype interview, or maybe even in real life, to tell our viewers about the details of the trip. I really wish you could make things happen. And I'm wishing for all the best for the Solar Voyager. Let it reach its destination safely and come back.
That's okay with us, but do not hesitate to help us already by achieving our final goal. We need the support from everyone. If there is a possibility to join us, to help us realizing our project. And that can be done on several ways, but if there is the willing to change the linear economy to a circular one, if you want to work with waste materials, but still struggling how to achieve that, then please join us and let's see if we can together make a strong, solid story out of it and be a part of it.
If you, my friends, are curious about ecology and you feel like you want to help, but you don't know how, simply start by sharing this story that you heard just now. Share the story of Solar Voyager with your friends. Tell them about Clean to Antarctica project. It's really and truly a wonderful and inspiring project. On my behalf, I wish the best of luck to Edwin and his team. We support their thoughts and ideas. If you feel the same, join their community and see whether there's anything you can do to help. Thank you for watching us. We'll continue to search for more interesting people who work in waste. We will talk more about new ways of waste usage and we'll share it with you. Thank you very much for your attention. Goodbye.